Hello everyone, I am Prashant S.Malge, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology. Today we will see random test method for determining the test set required for testing a circuit. The learning outcome. At the end of the session, student will be able to explain the random test method for choosing the test. In a previous lecture, we have seen the path sensitizing method for determining the test set. But determining the test using path sensitizing concept becomes difficult when the circuit becomes larger. For example, if you consider a n variable function, there are 2^2^n possible functions. For example, here, if we consider a 2 variable function, so the 2 variable, there are 4 possible values. So for all these 4 combinations, the output of a circuit may be all zeros, 2 all ones. So there are these 16 possible functions. So 2^2^2, there is 2^4 equal to 16 possible functions are there. At end, every time our circuit is implementing one of the function, but because of some fault, maybe any of the 15 faulty circuit gets implemented. Now consider the XOR circuit. Here, let us consider all possible faults such as stuck at 0 and stuck at 1 on wires B, C, D, H, K and F. Now, if in the above circuit, if wire B is stuck at 0, that is B stuck at 0, which function the circuit will implement? Pause this video for a minute and write your answer. Okay. Now you might have written the answer. We'll see what happens when B is stuck at 0. When B is stuck at 0, now suppose if we consider the output of the circuit for input combination 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. As B is stuck at 0, that is this wire W1 is stuck at 0. For first two cases it is okay, the output will be, or the actual input applied will be 0, 0 and 0, 1. But here, although we are saying 1, 0 is input applied, but as B is stuck at 0, actual input goes is 0, 0. Therefore, we get the output 0. And here in this case 1, 1, but instead of that, as B is stuck at 0, that is W1 stuck at 0, the actual input is 0, 1, so output is 1. So the function is actual function implemented will be 0, 1, 0, 1, that is F5, that is F is equal to value of W2. So actually in case of XOR function, F6 function is to be implemented, that is the output should be 0, 1, 1, 0. But instead of that, a faulty function F5 is implemented. So in the same way, we can consider the fault on each and every wire, and we can see or we can find out which faulty circuit gets implemented because of that particular fault. So here is a summary of all these faults. So if B is stuck at 1, the function implemented is F10, that is W2 bar. C stuck at 0, the function will be W1 and so on. So as here we see, there are B, C, D, H, K. So there are 5 different wires. So each wire may have a fault stuck at 0 and stuck at 1. So in these cases, it may implement any of these 9 faulty functions, because H stuck at 0 as well as K stuck at 0 implements F15. Okay, so once again, here is a summary of the functions. Say for example, if a fault is D stuck at 0, the function implemented is F0. If the fault is K stuck at 1, the fault is F2. Faulty function implemented is F2. So if the fault is K stuck at 1, the faulty function implemented is F2 and so on. So Now, here we can test the circuit by selecting the test randomly. Let us assume that the first test selected randomly is W1, W2 equal to 0, 1. So, W1, W2, 0, 1 should produce an output 1. So, with 0, 1, the output should produce 0, 1. It means if the output we are getting is 1, it means that the function is F0, F2, then F3 and F10. Out of these four, faulty function is not implemented. So the first set distinguish the good circuit from the faulty circuit. So out of the total 9 faulty circuit, we can say that these four faulty circuit is not implemented, or the fault corresponding to these particular functions is not present in the circuit. Now suppose randomly selected second test is W1, W2 equal to 1, 1. This produces the correct output at 0. And if it produces the correct output at 0, it means that the other four functions like F5, in which case this 1, 1 should produce 1, F7, then F15 and F3 is not implemented. Although this F3 is already distinguished by the previous test vector 0, 1. So additionally, these three faulty circuit gets distinguished by the second test. And suppose if I consider the third test randomly chosen is 1, 0, which will produce the correct output as 1. And if it produces that correct output, it means that this F4 and F12, these two faulty circuits get distinguished from the good circuit. So, these three randomly selected tests distinguish all the faulty circuits, possible faulty circuits in the so these three randomly selected tests detect all the faulty circuits that involve in the faults. So these three randomly selected tests detects all the faulty circuits that are involved in the faults listed in the table. Moreover, here we have observed that the first two tests themselves have detected maximum number of faulty circuits. So this suggests that it is possible to use the random test method for determining the test set. In general, if you look at these particular functions, the first randomly selected test will distinguish 8 of the faulty circuits. Because suppose, for example, we are considering this fault correct circuit is producing output 0, then in first randomly selected test, 8 of the functions which are producing the output 1, so these faulty circuits get detected in the very first test. So in a randomly selected second test, remaining 4 out of remaining 8, rather the 4 out of remaining 8 will also get detected. So this way it is possible to derive the suitable test set by selecting random test. The probability that the first few tests detects a large portion of all possible faults is very high. Specifically, in a circuit consisting of two variable functions, the probability that each faulty circuit can be detected by the first test is P1 is equal to 1 upon 2 raised to 2 raised to 2 minus 1 into 2 raised to 2 raised to 2 minus 1, that is 8 divided by 15, that is 53%. So this is the ratio of the total number of faulty circuit that produces an output value different from the good circuit to the total number of faulty circuits. Because in case of a two variable functions, one of the function is a correct function and the remaining 15 may be faulty functions. So total faulty functions possible are 15. Out of that, 8 can be distinguished with the first test. Therefore, the probability of detecting faulty circuit by the first test is 0.53. So in case of a n variable function, the first test detects 2^2^n-1 out of 2^2^n-1 possible faulty functions. So with m test, the probability that a faulty circuit will detected is Pm is equal to 1/2^2^n-1 into summation I equal to 1 to m 2^2^2^n-i. So when I is equal to 1, this is 2^2^2^n-1. Say for example, in case of n equal to 2, is 2^3, that is 8 by 15. Plus, next time when I equal to 2, it will be 2^2, that is 4 minus 2, 2^2 is 4, so 4 by 15. When I equal to 3, it will be 2^2, 2^2, that is 4 minus 3, 1, so 2 by 15. So this way the probability can be calculated. So thus the random testing works particularly well for the circuits that do not have high fanin. The simplicity of this random testing is one of the attractive feature. So this is the effectiveness of random testing. Thus random testing finds very effective for testing some of the circuits. Thank you.